What's up, YouTube? So it's been a while since I've done a macOS Sierra review, and since Beta 6 launched yesterday, I wanted to jump back and take a look at it and see how it is improving over the latest betas. So this beta release, if you guys were looking for changes, you're not going to find anything. There was really just under the hood fixes in this release. It had really nothing to do with new features. I've looked and couldn't really find anything. So this is developer beta 6, and I'm just running my Geekbench here. I'm using Geekbench 4. This performance actually impressed me. There was a reason I wanted to do a video. Apple's doing really well with the macOS Sierra betas, and yeah, so I just wanted to share you guys here. This will take a little bit. Now in beta 5, I noticed a lot of graphics issues. My MacBook actually, when running a Heaven Bench, which is a video benchmarking tool, would get a line across the screen just right here. The screen would glitch out, and I'd have to force reboot the MacBook to fix it. So in this build, that's been corrected. That's something that I could point out that Apple definitely has improved the graphics handling, at least for this model. So, the Geekbench is almost done here. We'll just let it finish. All right, so we're complete here. This was a 64-bit test, and I'm running Geekbench 4 on the macOS Sierra. Now you can see here my single core score is quite high, 3,392. My multi-core score is high at 5,686, but it's in my testing here, I've actually had a better result, so I'm quite surprised at the low results here. Just as a comparison, a benchmark, obviously I can't show performance with my machine versus your machine, so I've just included here some stats in Geekbench on my model with my Intel i7, which I have a 2.7 gigahertz i7. So the average score, which you can see mine is a little higher here for the single core, and then multi-core score, a lot of people see I was hitting about 6,000 as well, so there must be just other applications running. Now the next thing I'm going to run is Heaven, and this is a video Geekbench. Basically, we can see how the MacBook handles under a lot of video load. So let's check it out. Now this model in El Capitan here usually ran at about 15 to 30 frames per second. And it was fairly smooth, where even on here I can notice it's not doing too well. So we're going to run again a benchmark here, and we'll be back. All right, guys, we're finally finished here. So the average frames per second was 13 frames per second, which is pretty low. The max frames per second that it recorded was 30 frames, and then the minimum was 5 frames. So they have done major improvements. Like I said, some of these betas just crashed Heaven and it wouldn't even run. So I'm very impressed. Again, this is a beta, so it's not meant to be gaming or anything on. I hope this kind of gives you guys a little bit of insight why you should not use betas. They're just not ready for public use yet. Whether Apple slaps a public beta with the P word on it doesn't mean that it's going to run stable. So again, take this with a grain of salt. There's a reason I try not to do too many beta videos, just because I don't want to give the betas a bad name. Apple is definitely working on it, and they've done some definite improvements. So I'm really happy here with how Heaven runs on the latest beta. It's not the best, but it works. Now we're just going to jump back in here, and I'm going to cover a couple more things. Opening applications, launching, having a whole bunch of things running at once seems to be working pretty good. I do have, as you can see there, a little snitch, so a firewall going. Coming in and out of animations seems to be pretty quick. Again, guys, I'm really sorry about the camera angle here. To be able to perform this test properly, I have to record the screen in this way. Doing a screen capture using a program like ScreenFlow would just taint the benchmarks. So another thing to point out, ScreenFlow doesn't work. It's still unable to capture video screen sharing, as well as QuickTime, which is another tool I've used to do a lot of screen captures, don't function in macOS Sierra. So it's made recording these betas very difficult to actually share with you guys. So as you can see there, I recorded a bit of my screen. It recorded no audio, no video. But overall, the betas are running very well. As you can see here, all of the animations jump through very quickly. The applications open up, the widgets load. So what do you guys think here? How are you liking macOS Sierra? And are you ready to use it come September? We are getting very close to the public launch, so we should be seeing it available very soon. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you like this video. Subscribe to the channel again for more videos on macOS Sierra as we come up to the launch. I will cover more, and we'll see you guys again next time. Cheers.